morning, family. I'd like to take time to introduce the staff for today. Once again, my name is Jerome Cuthbert III. I have Mr. Wayne Dixon, who will be your funeral assistant for today. You feel free to have any questions or any concerns. You can find and grab any one of us at any time. We'll do our best to answer that question best I can. This is the starting of you all this station period. With the respect of keeping the casket open for the whole service, we just ask that you return to your seats 5 minutes to 11, just so the service can start properly. Don't feel confined to your seats and that you can be able to greet family or friends if they come and do so. We'll be checking you all periodically.
Thank you. step of mine.
Thank you.
Have you ever had one?
Thank you.
We'll talk to you later.
I'm going to start the service. I think there's someone coming in.
Family and friends, at this time, the family is requested to go ahead and close the casket and get into service. So at this time, we're going to allow them to have their final view for the media family only. Is anyone on this road that would like to go up this time? On the second road, anyone like to go up at this time for your final view? All right, this time, first row, please. This begins the services. God bless you.
Good morning. I'm going to open up the service with a prayer. Father Yahweh, we are here today to remember the life of Christopher. Father, I pray that you be with his mom, Tina, his father, Greg, his sister, Jasmine, his brother Jamal, Leah, and sister Leah, Father. I just pray that you be with the family to give them comfort on this day and the days to come. Father, we may want to ask the question why, but the answer is not for us to know. For life and death is in thy hand, Father. And we accept thy decision, for we know there's a day coming that we will see Chris again. So, Father, today, as the family remembers his life and celebrate the memories, I pray that you send the comforter, Father, to be with them and to strengthen them to get through this time of sorrow. Father, I just thank you for the opportunity. We thank you for the opportunity for the years that he was in our life, Father. And we just thank you for this day and the days to come. For we know that you will be with us. We know that you will be with the family to strengthen them, to comfort them. And your love will be with them. And your arms will be around them to give them the strength to continue on. So on this day, Father, joy will come. And we thank you, Father, for all that you have done for this family and all that you will do. For all that we have and all that we are is because of thy love and mercy and because of the grace of thy son, Yahshua, our Messiah. And it's in his name that I ask these things today, Father. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
At this time, we will have a musical selection by the Assembly of Yahweh and Brandywine.
Or is it me?
have a scripture reading by Francis Ford Spence. Reading from the National NIV version of the Bible. I'm going to read Ecclesiastes 1 through 4 and also verse 20. There is a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant, a time to uproot, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to tear down, and a time to build, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance. All go to the same place, all come from dust, and to dust all return. May the Father add a blessing to the reading.
Thank you, Ms.
At this time, I would like to say a few things about Chris and to the family, and I'm going to read scripture. On Wednesday, September 8, 1982, Christopher Blaine Plunkett was born. And today, 14,615 days later, we remember and celebrate his life. His mom says he was an old soul. I don't know what that means, but that's what mom says, so it has to be true. She said he had old-fashioned ideas. He never liked getting into trouble. He was always wanting to help others. When he started Head Start, there was a time when his teacher was concerned about something Chris was doing at school. So the teacher called Tina. And so when she talked to Tina, the teacher said that Chris didn't want to sing his ABCs. So when Tina asked him why didn't he want to sing his ABCs, Chris said, "Why do I have to sing them? I already know them." She said he was always looking out for the little guy. He was such a kind-hearted person. And as he grew into a man, he was always looking to help others. He was never an extravagant person. He wasn't materialistic. And he didn't like people making a fuss over him. He never saw color. He just saw people. And as a black male in today's society, he was never in trouble with the law. And Tina says she never had to worry about him walking the streets. And I'm also told that Lily and James are his heart. I would like to go to the Old Testament and read Psalms 23. It says, "Yahweh is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth my soul, he leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul, he leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of Yahweh forever." And I would like to go to the book of 1 Corinthians 15. I'm going to start in verse 35. Some will say, "How are the dead raised up? And with what body do they come? Thou fool, that which thou sowest is not quickened except it die. And that which thou sowest not that body that shall be but bare grain. It may chance of wheat or of some other grain. But Elohim giveth the body as it hath pleased him, and to every seed his own body. All flesh is not the same flesh, but there is one kind of flesh of men, another flesh of beasts, another of fishes, and another of birds. There are also celestial bodies and bodies terrestrial. But the glory of the celestial is one, and the glory of the terrestrial is another. There is one glory of the sun and another glory of the moon, and another glory of the stars. For one star differs from another star in glory. So also is the resurrection of the dead. It is sown in corruption. It is raised in incorruption. It is sown in honor, in dishonor. It is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness. It is raised in power. It is sown a natural body. It is raised a spiritual body. When our Savior was on this earth for almost 34 years, he had a natural body. And even he could not return to his Father unless he had that spiritual body. So just as Chris, the natural body is now at rest. And we're waiting on that day when he will be risen to receive that spiritual body. There is a spiritual body, there is a natural body. And so it is written, the first Adam was made a living soul, and the last Adam was made a life-giving spirit. Albeit that was not first which is spiritual, but that which is natural, and afterward that which is spiritual. The first Adam is of the earth, earthy. The second Adam is Yahshua from heaven. As is the earthy, such are they also that are earthy. And as is the heavenly, such are they also that are heavenly. And as we have borne the image of the earthy, it's promised to us that we shall also bear the image of the heavenly. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of Yahweh, neither doth corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. And O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of the sin is the law. But thanks be to Yahweh, which giveth us the victory through our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of Yahweh, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain. And him, so to Tina, to Jasmine, to the family, I say, be not dismayed, for Yahweh is your Elohim. He will strengthen you. He will help you to get through this difficult time. He will uphold you with the right hand of his righteousness. And though your hearts may be filled with sorrow and pain, know that in the morning, one day to come, you will have joy. But Father Yahweh will give you joy. He will give you happiness. He will let his light shine on you. And he will continue to show you his love. At this time, I'm going to ask Raymond and Charlene to come forward to provide remarks by friends and family.
I was Chris's roommate for the past year, and many of the things that were said here have been absolutely true. To say that you don't really know somebody until you've lived with them. Well, I lived with Chris, and every meal was like, it always had something for me. I really liked the Chinese food. We used to go to this Chinese place all the time. And we'd get, like, he'd ask me for the shrimp because he liked jumbo shrimp. He was studying to be a technician. He He had multiple A-plus books, pretty bad books, and working really hard on it, and was really proud of his job that he had just got. And he was definitely making ground. He was working two jobs so he could pay his bills, and then he got that job. I told him, gave him some advice. I said, "Hey, Chris, enjoy your life, little man. Take some time." Forced him into the gym after that. That's how Chris would handle things, and he just kept pushing forward. He was, you know, he really loved chili dogs and pierogies. If you never had a pierogi, it's kind of like ravioli stuff with mashed potatoes. Man, he cooked those things a lot. And he really liked, our group. We used to play poker all the time, and watched a lot of anime, and enjoyed Ninja Turtles and Batman. And as you see in the program here, he's got Batman. So, prominent in his room right now, he's got the Batman hat and everything. He had it set up. I was trying to get him a Batman chair at some point. That would have been pretty cool. But, I'm going to miss him.
Child does not have to be born of your blood to be your family. Love binds us in ways we can't imagine. And as we grow, some things change and some things stay the same. But one thing that does stay the same is the love that we have. It grows and it deepens for our children. It's an interesting thing to watch our children become adults and change and take on things that they like to do that may be different from how we brought them up. And one thing that I was very proud of, I'm proud of all of our children, but I was very proud of Chris lived a life that was enjoyable to him. And I love that he lived life on his own terms. And I think that Greg and Tina and I tried to instill that in all of our children. I met Chris when he was 9, he was always a kind and gentle child. I gave him the name Christopher Robin because there was a heated debate when Jamal was little, who was Robin and who was Batman. Jamal was determined to be Batman, and Chris gave it up and said, "All right, I'm Robin." And so from that day forward, I called him Christopher Robin. Chris was always a very thoughtful and loving and kind child. And he was always a very good brother to all of our children. And I watched him and Jazz and Jamal grow and play. And Jalea came up very late to bring it up the rear. And he still made sure he had a relationship with his younger sister too. And I'm very thankful for that. I'm thankful for the times that I got to share with him. I'm very thankful to Greg and Tina to allow me to share this razor all the way to the very day that Chris left this earth. And I'm forever grateful. And I'm grateful for the friendship that we've developed over the years. And I thank you for that.